The Winter University Games are fast approaching, and the German figure skater Peter Liebers is training hard. He was eighth at the last Olympic Games, so he's a top-level athlete, but he's also a student of biotechnology at the Beuth University in Berlin. Peter's always been aware that he has to think about another life when his sporting days are over. You know, in Germany, I have to say, you can't earn your living from figure skating. So you have to focus at an early stage on your prospects after your sports career. So obviously, my studies are very important. Biology was his passion at high school, and since 2010, Peter's been attending university 4 days a week for 2 hours of lectures each day. He trains twice a day as well, before and after university, a full day overall for this highly motivated student. I really want to try to use what I've learned during my studies, especially in the biotechnological domain, to work in a sports discipline. You know, you can do a lot in the area of injury rehabilitation, where you try to improve the healing process with biotechnological procedures. And what I want to do is to go in that direction. So his plan is to do work in stem cell technology, to use the athlete's own cells in case of a serious injury. And Peter Liebers has had a lot of injuries in his career, so he has plenty of motivation. Of course, you need a surgeon for this kind of operation, but the procedures you need to use these cells so that you can complete the operation, well, that's a biotechnological question. And of course, there's always the question, it's an ethical one, of how compatible is it with anti-doping? That's a very touchy subject. For me, it would be an interesting project, no question of that, to find the tools, the legal tools, to help athletes after injuries, to enable them to refocus on their sport more quickly and get back into their sport. For the German skater, it's not easy to combine studies and sport, especially leading up to important competitions. But Beuth University supports top-level athletes like Peter Liebers. Last year, I received a prize as an athlete from Beuth University for my sport, and it certainly helped me financially to combine both sport and study. Peter studies everywhere he can during his trips abroad, during competitions, and the university has helped him by setting up a special service for him. The university helped me with the online learning system where I can find the lectures that I have to study. Discipline is something that athletes have to have to be structured, even when you don't feel like you have the capacity to fight through the challenges. Peter's father is a skater, and Peter himself took to the ice at the age of 6. But his career has been marked by several serious injuries. Altogether, he's lost 4 years through physical setbacks. I'm not the only skater who's had to face serious injuries. There are plenty of other skaters who faced it too. Such is life. Life is like that. And I simply have to do my best. A broken ankle, fibula, sacrum, and every time, Peter simply rebooted himself. From the beginning, it was very clear to me that I would continue. I think subconsciously, I have never permitted myself to have doubts. Doubts that I'd feel like quitting my career simply because I was injured. Peter was once again unlucky, only last September. He fell on the ice during a pirouette and broke his left shoulder. It required an operation and rest for 2 months. The preparations for the upcoming Universiade and the European Championships are seriously behind schedule. So how is the shoulder now? Yeah, it's quite good. I'm not 100% fit. The shoulder needs a long time to heal. The mobility in the joint was reduced. It needs more time. I have a lack of power, and I need more mobility in that shoulder joint to be 100% once again. But I am on the way. And for the European Championships and the Winter Universiade, I think I'm going to be ready.
Richtung Europameisterschaften und Universiade werde ich, denke ich, wieder 100% fit sein.
Peter Liebers had a great year in 2014. Sixth at the European Championships in Budapest and eighth at the Olympic Games in Sochi. Rewards for all the effort that he'd put into the sport. Not to give up. That became our motto. Because in the end, you have to stand up again when you fall. That's something I've been able to do very well every time, in fact. Peter found the key to his success 4 years ago. After missing the Vancouver Olympics, Peter changed things. And step by step, he's built up a team who help him to come back stronger after those injuries. After all those successes that you've had, after your ups, like the Olympic Games, to be able to perform again at the best level, well, that's a success that you learn to appreciate, to enjoy. Now, to help him enjoy and perform at his best, a psychology coach, better physical preparation, a choreography lesson or two in Toronto, combined with training sessions under his coach, Viola Striegler, in Berlin. Technically, I was always good. That's been my strength. But I had a weakness in the artistic realm for a long time. There, though, I've now closed the gap in the last 3 or 4 years, I guess, and I've learned a lot. Peter is now able to show more emotion on the ice. And at the Winter Universiade in February, he'll perform the same routines he used during the Sochi Olympic Games. And despite those injury setbacks, he's confident of a place on the podium. I was at the Olympic Games, and the Universiades are the Olympics for students, so of course, I want to be one of the best there. I'm really looking forward to it.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders. When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade. The home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.